Hi, Khan Center for Cardiac Longevity, Dr. Khan here. So, some important new research that leads me to a larger topic. Out of Korea comes a study of people with adult diabetes, either randomized to the standard Korean Diabetic Association diet, which is much like the American one, or a very high complex carb diet with brown rice as its staple and no animal products. So there's essentially no oil in this diet. There is no butter, no dairy, no cheese, no chicken, no turkey, no meat, no eggs. What happened? There was a far better improvement in diabetic control, even though these people were pounding down 80% of their calories from carbs. There is the drop in hemoglobin A1C being much more accelerated when you add complex carbs and take away fats to the diabetic diet in an adult. That's been shown previously by Dr. Neil Barnard, and an amazing researcher at Yale named Gerald Schulman has shown that muscle and liver cells are flooded with fat droplets in people with prediabetes or adult type 2 diabetes. If you lower the fat in the diet, you get the fat droplets out and you resolve the insulin resistance. So don't be afraid of complex carbs. But what about the internet? What about this morning on Facebook? What about everywhere? Butter, cheese, meat, low carb, high fat diets, LCHF. You'd think there was some science out there to support it. You'd think that longevity would be improved. You'd think that heart patients would be doing well to follow a LCHF. Low carb, high fat diet. That is all bull pucky. If you've had a heart attack and you follow a low carb, high fat diet, you increase your risk of dying, that's a bad one, by 50 to 60%. That's published in 2014 from a large database. If you want a larger database, you go to 1 million people published in the last 3 to 4 years, where those that followed low carb, high fat diets had increased death rates. Death, bad one, bad side effect to choosing a diet that a lot of people find popular. Well, if you track a lot of the spokespeople for a low-carb, high-fat diet down, you find that they take money from the egg industry, particularly the dairy industry and the meat industry. I'm not saying all of them, but in some of them, it's hard to track it down. But there are large research foundations now funding spokespeople, authors, physicians, and scientists to promote the idea that low-carb, high-fat diets, you can call it Atkins, you could call it Sugar Busters, you can call it South Beach, which is a modified version, but it's not a diet like the proven science in a randomized study that shows eating a lot of complex carbs, even brown rice, reverses adult diabetes. Isn't that crazy? So you have a wonderful day as you consider what's the truth, what's the science. Ask questions. Be sure to ask, where's the disclosure? I own a plant-based restaurant, totally in concert with recommendations of the American Dietetic Association and other large bodies of scientific experts. There it is. Be careful who you take advice from.